G'day Whovians and welcome to this new video. So last weekend we got a full length trailer for the 60th anniversary specials that gave us a look at so many huge, exciting, scary moments from the upcoming specials. And there is so much to discuss from the trailer. So in this video I'm going to break it down, discuss and theorise about some of the things that we saw in the trailer. Before I begin, make sure that you do leave a like and subscribe for more Doctor Who content. Now, let's break down the trailer. The trailer kicks off with a shot of London, the same shot that we got in the shorter trailer that was released earlier this year. Our wonderful Donna Noble is having a conversation with her mother Sylvia, and from the conversation we have the audio, "Sometimes I think there's something missing, like I've had something lovely and it's gone. I lie in bed thinking, what have I lost?" Over this dialogue we get a few different shots in the trailer, from the Doctor running from something, Donna looking rather frightened, and a shot of the Doctor popping his head out. Following that, we have a few extra clips of the Doctor looking like he's exploring something. First guess is that he's investigating something. Location, absolutely no idea. It doesn't give much away. However, I think that these shots are all from the same scene. We have a lovely little shot of the TARDIS landing and the Doctor sticking his head out. These shots we've seen before, and I'm guessing this is how the specials will actually begin, and that this is immediately after the regeneration. Following on, we have a new shot of the Doctor and Donna, and it looks like this is when they first encounter each other in the specials. With that, we have some flashback moments to series 4 of Journey's End, with the Doctor's hand and him wiping Donna's memory. And we have a little clip of the Doctor engaging in conversation with Ruth Madley's character, and her character is named Shirley Ann Bingham. Now, we don't know much about her, but she does appear later on in the trailer as well, so I'm going to discuss that in a little bit. Over these clips, we have dialogue of the Doctor saying, "I've got this friend called Donna Noble. I had to wipe her memory to save her life. But if she remembers me, she will die." Next, we have a few little clips of a spaceship crashing through the sky with the Doctor and Rose, played by Yasmin Finney, witnessing it. The dialogue of the Doctor continues with him saying, "So what happens next? A spaceship crashes right in front of her. It's like she's drawing us in." The Doctor says she's drawing us in. Who could he be talking about? Donna, perhaps, but if he's saying that Donna is drawing us in, then who is us? We have a few short clips of Donna first interacting with the Meep, played by Miriam Margolyes, with Donna poking it in the eye thinking that it's a stuffed toy. We see the Doctor out on the street with another clip of Donna and Rose. This time, Donna screaming, "We've got a bloody Martian in the shed." I like that. It's kind of like a little callback to her first episode, The Runaway Bride, where we see Donna just basically calling the Doctor a Martian. I don't know if that is a callback, but for me, that's immediately what my mind goes to. Now, these clips obviously go together. This is obviously attracting the Doctor's attention as he's peeking through the letterbox of Donna's home. We also have a short clip of my favourite Doctor Who mother, Sylvia Noble, with Sylvia shouting, "Don't look." Now I'm guessing this is Sylvia telling Donna not to look at the Doctor, as we've seen in the first trailer. Also, the Meep clinging to Donna's leg as it shouts, "Meep, Meep." Honestly, this scene looks chaotic and hilarious, and I can't wait to see it. And of course, Sylvia slapping the Doctor across the head. We can't forget this little hilarious moment, with the Doctor saying, "Here we go again." Next, we get our first look at the Wrath Warriors, I think I'm pronouncing them correctly, in this trailer, firing their weapons. Now, if you're unfamiliar with the Wrath Warriors, they were constructed as a kind of police force to deal with the Meeps. So obviously, they're here to collect the Meep. They first appeared in the Doctor Who comic, Doctor Who and the Star Beast. And next, we see the Doctor deflecting bullets or something. I don't quite know what's happening here.
Use the Force.
Maybe he's using regeneration energy in a new way, possibly. Either way, I'm very intrigued. Next up, there is a very small, very quick clip of the Doctor and Donna in some sort of spaceship. These clips are followed by the Doctor running through the same spaceship. We're then taken back to the attack on Donna's home, as it looks like her home is completely being destroyed, and a lot of chaos on the street with soldiers running about and cars flipping. Are these soldiers working for UNIT? My guess is yes, they're UNIT soldiers. Dialogue over this scene is again the Doctor saying, "I don't believe in destiny, but if destiny exists, then it's heading for Donna Noble." We have two very intense shots of the Doctor in what looks like unit headquarters, followed on by a chaotic shot of Neil Patrick Harris's character, and it's been officially confirmed that he's playing, drum roll please, the Celestial Toymaker, which I guess we all kind of knew that anyway, but it hadn't been confirmed. These scenes here of the Toymaker dancing in the street with Donna looking on were witnessed being filmed. I think you can find the clips online, like somewhere online. I've definitely seen them. And the dialogue over this scene is again the Doctor saying, "And I've got a memory. After a very long time, something is coming back." Next up, we have a very creepy scene of an alleyway, followed by Rose speaking to the Meep, saying, "Who are they?" The Meep replies, "Monsters." Can I just say, the marketing of the Meep is going to go off the charts. Like, I think the BBC need to release a life-size Meep like Disney released a life-size Baby Yoda. I mean, I don't know about you, but I would definitely pay for that. Again, another chaotic shot of the Toymaker with his creepy laugh playing over it. Now, honestly, I think that Neil Patrick Harris is going to be such a brilliant villain. Like, from what we've seen of him so far, I absolutely love him and I love his take on the Toymaker. And I think he's going to give us one of the greatest Doctor Who villain performances in Doctor Who history, which I think is going to stand out in the 60th anniversary. Like, I think he's going to be phenomenal. We have an exchange between the Doctor and Donna, possibly on a spaceship. I'm not 100% certain of that. The background looks very spaceshipy. Is that even a word? Probably not, but I'm going with it. But the dialogue goes, "Donna, there's something so bad, the TARDIS ran away. Doctor, yeah, Donna. Then we go and kick its ass." Donna Noble, the badass. I absolutely love this moment, but also, what could be so bad that it actually makes the TARDIS run away? Like, I'm very intrigued to see what the cause of the TARDIS's fear is. Like, this is such a great little moment. Avengers Tower? Oh wait, no, Unit Headquarters, sorry. In this moment, we can see the Doctor and the TARDIS being airlifted to Unit Headquarters. And I mean, I guess it's better than the last time Unit transported the Doctor somewhere. A shot of the Doctor shouting Kate Lethbridge-Stewart. Kate has now encountered the 10th Doctor, the 11th Doctor, the 12th Doctor, the 13th Doctor, and the 14th Doctor. Like, she's collecting them like they're Infinity Stones. So in the trailer, we get a little discussion between the Doctor and Kate, with Kate saying, "What do we do this time, Doctor? How do we fight the human race?" From that dialogue and the clips that follow, my theory is that the Toymaker is sort of manipulating the human race and has caused them to fight one another and maybe even turn on the Doctor. We have a shot of some sort of force field or something around the TARDIS, as if it's been transported somewhere. We have a very quick shot of the Doctor looking up and an aeroplane flying dangerously close to the ground. With this, I'm definitely sticking to my theory that the Toymaker is controlling the humans, including the pilots of the plane. Some sort of purple void, a gateway or a doorway perhaps, maybe even a teleport? Dialogue from the Doctor says, "Something entered this world." We have the Doctor and Donna entering the Toymaker's toy shop and confronting him. Dialogue from the Toymaker, "Oh, but he's recognizing me," with Donna asking, "Who is he?" I think this is going to be the first interaction that we'll see between the Doctor and the Toymaker in the specials. It very much seems like this is like the first moment for these two characters to come together. We see some sort of mechanical device dive into the ground as London begins to rip in half. This scene honestly scares me. Like, it feels like such a huge end of the world scenario, and I'm very excited to see how this plays out. There is also some dialogue in this moment that I can't quite make out. Something awaits, or something along those lines? I think it says the one who waits. We see the Toymaker in a kind of historical outfit as Kate Stewart shouts, "Open fire." Also, look at the door that is located behind Kate. One, why is a door in the middle of her office like that? And two, look at the little clown-like face on it. Does the door lead to the Toymaker's den? I think it could be a gateway for him to have easy access into UNIT. Again, a few little action scenes with the Doctor and a heartwarming moment between the Doctor and Donna. Next up, we have a shot, a very scary, emotional shot of the Doctor shouting, "Why does it always have to be this?" Basically, I've got a bad feeling about this scene. We see the Doctor looking up at the Toymaker, who is now gigantic and is controlling something with puppet strings. Controlling the humans, perhaps? Yeah, I'm not sure. Either way, this scene looks really cool and looks really intense. Another scene, which I'm guessing comes from the previous scene of the Doctor looking as if he's losing the battle or losing control. Next, we have a standoff between the Doctor and the Toymaker on the UNIT helipad, with the Toymaker controlling a giant cannon or a giant gun. This scene looks ridiculously cool. And then the Doctor shouts, "Your fight is with me." But also, look at Donna and Kate behind him. They look weirdly calm. I think that the Toymaker has taken control of them or frozen them or something like that. Also, speaking of Ruth Madley again, her Shirley character is back in this scene, so obviously she works at UNIT with Kate. Perhaps we could see her in the UNIT spin-off show that's hopefully happening. Another little clip that truly terrifies me, Donna looking awfully scared, and she puts her hands up to surrender. Oh my god, please, Russell T Davies, please don't kill Donna Noble. If anything, I think we might lose Donna in this story. My heart is going to shatter because she's one of my favourite companions of all time, and there is a huge rumour circulating the internet that she will die, and I sadly think it's going to be true. And the trailer is nearing the end with this heartbreaking little moment between the Doctor and Donna, with the Doctor's dialogue saying, "I don't know if I can save your life this time." Like I mentioned, I think Donna might actually die. But it doesn't end just yet, as we're given a very quick shot of the TARDIS possibly under attack, a clip of a war between the soldiers and the Wrath Warriors, looking like it takes place early on with the action scenes on the street, and the Doctor and Donna running from something in a twisting hallway. And look at the playing cards on the wall. My theory for this particular scene is that this hallway is a trap or a hallucination set up by the Toymaker. We have a very quick clip of the Toymaker surrounded by rose petals. Rose petals. Could this be a reference to Rose, played by Billy Piper, or Rose, Donna's daughter? We get another shot of the Doctor in UNIT headquarters. On the screens behind him, we have some sort of ventriloquist dummy. There we go. So my theory is that the Toymaker in this scene is taunting UNIT or messing with their technology, something like that. And the trailer ends with one last clip of the Toymaker shouting, "Worldwide premiere!" But of course we can't end the trailer without one last look at our next Doctor, Shuti Gatwa. Also, listen to the regeneration sound playing over this. It very much sounds like the 13th Doctor's grunt. So I have a theory that perhaps we will see the 13th Doctor actually regenerate into Shuti after all. Maybe. Or I think we're definitely going to see the 13th Doctor in some form, because it very much sounds like her. So what do you think of the 60th anniversary trailer? Do you have any theories for the 60th anniversary? Let me know in the comments down below. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you guys next time.
Don't forget to click below to subscribe to the Whovian Comedy YouTube channel.